वकफ बाय यूज, दैट्स अ कांसेप्ट ऑफ वकफ बाय यूज. यू सी दैट नियर दिल्ली पार्लियामेंट, देयर इज अ पार्लियामेंट, देयर इज अ बिग, देयर इज अ मॉस्क, मोर देन 200 इयर्स ओल्ड मॉस्क. नोबडी नो दैट हाउ इट बिकम, व्हाट वाज एक्चुअली द प्रॉपर्टी डील ऑफ दैट मॉस्क इटसेल्फ. You are removing the clause of wakaf by use through this amendment. That means there is going to be a dispute in each and every mosque where there is no deed. What will be the happen? Your fundamental idea is to create conflict and create the anger between the communities and make violence everywhere. Okay, I can understand if you want a prospective bill on this cross. There is still bit of justification. Retrospectively, you are taking over all the pilgrim centers which have no deed. There were traditional ages one. Point is that every legislation, there should be a motive of, there should be an intention of well-being. That is what we are witnessing. That should come from the heart. Every legislation has to come from the ruler's duty is to make the decision which come from the heart. Now you have ill motive to divide the people of this country. That is why we bring the bill. Therefore, we are totally objecting the bill. This bill cannot be passed, sir. This bill cannot be introduced, sir.
इस तरफ चाहता हूँ आपके माध्यम से कि मैं वाहिद आदमी हूँ इस सदन में जिसमें वन मैन कमेटी आपके द्वारा बनाई गई सरकार के, और मैं उसमें पेश हुआ 123 प्रॉपर्टी में. जस्टिस आर्यन ने जो रिपोर्ट पेश की आज तक वक्फ बोर्ड को नहीं बताया गया, चूंकि वो आपकी मंशा के खिलाफ थी और गवर्नमेंट की मंशा के मुताबिक नहीं थी. 123 प्रॉपर्टी में जब मंशा के खिलाफ हमारे नहीं आए, मंशा के मुताबिक नहीं आई, तो हमने टू मैन कमेटी बनाई और टू मैन कमेटी ने भी कोई रिपोर्ट वक्फ बोर्ड को नहीं दी, जबकि वक्फ एक्ट जो है 1995 जो है वो पार्लियामेंट से पास शुदा है कि हम पार्लियामेंट के जो एहतराम है उसका नहीं कर रहे, उसके हुकूक का. इसी तरह से सर सूबाई हुकूमतों को इख्तियार दिया गया. सर हिंदू एंटोमन में जो कर्नाटका और तमिलनाडु में है वहां कोई मुस्लिम नहीं हो सकता, और 26 में आर्टिकल 26 का वायोलेशन है. चार धाम में ये लिखा हुआ वाजे तौर पर कि सिर्फ हिंदू होगा. बिहार उड़ीसा में भी यही लिखा हुआ है. पंजाब हरियाणा में गुरुद्वारा प्रबंधन कमेटी में सिर्फ सिख होगा ओनली, और ये उनका अधिकार है जिसको माना गया है, लेकिन मुस्लिम के साथ में यह अन्याय क्यों है? और सुन लीजिए सर मैं आपकी तवज्जो दिलाता हूं, दुनिया का सबसे पहला वक्फ खाने काबा मक्के में है, क्या हम उसके ऊपर भी सवाल उठाएंगे कि वहां पर भी हमारा कोई हिंदू भाई हो? हम अपने वकार को, अपनी इज्जत को, अपने मुल्क की, अपने शान को, अपने संविधान को खुद अपने पैरों तले रौंद रहे हैं. और वक्फ एक मुसलमानों का मजहबी अमल है, एक मजहबी फरीजा है, इससे उनको महरूम कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के जरिए से भी कोई ताकत नहीं कर सकती. सर ये हम बहुत बड़ी गलती करने जा रहे हैं जिसका खुमियाजा हमें अभी नहीं सदियों तक हम भुगतते रहेंगे, क्योंकि हम खुद अपने कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन को, संविधान को उसकी पवाली कर रहे हैं.
इट्स अ वेरी सैड डे इन पार्लियामेंट टुडे. दिस ईयर व्हेन वी केम बैक टू द पार्लियामेंट, many of the members took their oath with the constitution in hand. That was to protect the constitution, to imply that the constitution is supreme and it has to be protected. But today we see that this government is blatantly going against the constitution. This bill is just not against the constitution, it's against federalism, it's against a religious minority, it is against human beings.
Yes,
it shuns justice in every possible way. The bill violates article 25 and article 26 of the constitution, which says we have the right to follow a religion and the rights of religious the religion to follow and manage its own religious affairs. The bill allows non-Muslims to be a part of the workforce. Like many people here have raised a question that will it be possible for a Muslim or a Christian to be part of the board which manages a Hindu temple?
Yes.
Would you allow that?
No. Also Sikhs.
And Sikhs.
Parsis.
Parsis. Would you allow that? No. But then, why should somebody who does not believe in a particular religion have the right to make decisions on behalf of that religion? Is this not unfair? Is this not against the law of justice?
There's people who actually are running this organization today. So I request with full humility to this government to either withdraw it, and if they do not want to withdraw it, at least send it to a standing committee or make a committee together of the entire all party meeting and then do it. Please do not push agendas without consultations. I will not
competence to make these amendments. This bill patently violates the principles provided in Article 14, 15 and 25, sir. It is both discriminatory, arbitrary. It is a grave attack on the basic structure of the Constitution as it violates the principle of judicial independence, separation of powers. Sir, one thing has to be understood, that the waqf management of a property is an essential religious practice for a Muslim. By denying legal recognition to waqf al-aulad under Clause 4 and waqf by user under Section 3R1, government has sought to severely restrict how Muslims can manage their waqf property. Sir, in fact, Hindu endowment boards are recognized even by usage and custom. Here you're asking for documentation. No existing law, whether non-religious or personal, limits the right of a person to will their property or dispose it. But what you're doing over here, a Hindu can give through will his complete property to his daughter or son. I as a Muslim cannot do, I can only give one third. But what you are doing, I can gift, but I cannot give it in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now you are stopping me from praying. Now what you are doing, you are restraining waqf al-aulad. That is not only discriminatory and violating Article 25, sir. There is no limit on anyone to will their property dispose of. Sir, to insist that a person has practiced Islam for 5 years. Sir, ek do minute diye, sabko diya. अगर कल कोई आके बोलेगा कि नहीं मैं 5 साल से इस्लाम प्रैक्टिस नहीं कर रहा हूं, कौन डिसाइड करेगा सर? और एक न्यू कन्वर्ट है, डज ही हैज टू वेट फॉर 5 years टू गिव हिज प्रॉपर्टी टू वक्फ? इजंट दैट वायलेशन ऑफ राइट टू फ्रीडम ऑफ रिलीजन? सर, अनदर पॉइंट सर, नाउ नो सच प्रोविजन एग्जिस्ट फॉर हिंदू एंडोमेंट और सिख गुरुद्वारा प्रबंधक कमेटी. The irony of the amendment, sir, is that non-Muslims can become member of CWC as WB, but he cannot dedicate waqf. Arbitrous, why is arbitrous? Sir, existing law protected the status of registered waqf properties. You have replaced that by empowering collector to determine title. You are violating principle of rights of justice, that one may not be a judge in their own cause. Section 61, if DM says to Matawalli, make this masjid as a government property, if does not listen, punishable offense. This is again separation of powers, part of which is basic structure. This bill excludes tribunal decisions from being final. If collector has been replaced by tribunal, and who's going to look in, sit in the tribunal? A retired government judge and a retired government employee. How can the...
My constituency in city Kolkata, I have huge number of Muslims and full of waqf properties and everything. I am little aware, I will speak only few points, that it is a violative of Article 14, which is equality before law. It is unconstitutional due to violation of Article 25 and 26 of the Constitution, which talks about right to freedom of religion. It is opposing that right. It is against federalism, as land has stated, the 7th schedule of the Constitution is a state subject. In Sardar Sayyedana Taher Saifuddin Sahib versus State of Bombay, 1962, the Supreme Court ruled that state should not interfere in the matters of religion. This bill is divisive. The bill is anti-constitutional. The bill is anti-federal. Therefore, I strongly object to the...
Just it. First of all, This is beyond the legislative competency of the central government to make this amendment which touches in respect of the land coming within the 7th schedule. Property is the question which can be decided by the only the civil court, but no any authority under which law this power has been given to decide the property, title of the property, how it can be done. Civil law will be taken away. This bill is completely contrary to the constitutional morality. This bill is intended to, this is a malice, this suffers from malice in law. It's a malicious legislation because this bill is targeting the Muslims of this country. Yes, this cannot be tolerated. There are a number of reasons. Sir, just 1 minute, sir. Not 1 minute, 15 seconds. Sir, before election, there was an attempt in the country that to make the country as a Hindu Rashtra, which has been rejected by the people of this country. This